Hello everyone, this is Shadow Dragon from the DCUO community, and I'm going to be going over the St. Patrick's Day event that started today. I actually had an old video for it, but what I'm trying to do this time around is I want to see if I could get all the different types of nodes so I could show you the most efficient way to do them. Now, I'm starting off on the villain side, but I may have to do this with two characters in order to get the full variety.
Greetings and salutations, Earth idiot! I am Mr. Mixius Spitalik, a being from the fifth dimension! I understand you Earth chumps have a legend about little green men. Well, how could I resist? Gather all 33 of me golden coins from pots of gold all over Metropolis! If you can!
Now, you actually get three quests packaged together. There's one for exploring Metropolis, which will appear once you get to Metropolis. Because if you just pick up the quest from Mixius Spitalik, all you get is the Fool and his gold. And that's the one where you have to get the 33 coins. But once you enter Metropolis, you're going to get another one to explore some of the landmarks. And then when you get close to Daily Planet, you get another quest for the race. So the quest with the coins, now this seems to change every year. And they redid like a lot of the payouts for the seasonals. So the quest with the coins awards you 6. The exploration gives you 4, for a total of 10. The race actually doesn't give you anything. But if you're like a new toon, it will give you a quest completion, so it'll work towards that feat. And you actually only need to run the race once. A platinum will get you an emblem, and just completing it gets you a feat. So if you just get the platinum on the first run, you never have to run the race again. But for the daily quest, all you have to do is locate the race. So you have to relocate the race every day. I mean, you don't actually have to because it doesn't pay out anything, but just to get rid of the thing in the journal. And if you don't have the feat for whatever the total number of quest completions is, it'll work towards that. So I'm actually on a new tune. This was the 100 skipper from the start. So it's a 100 skip tune on a premium account. So what I actually have to do is, actually the first thing you should do is you should highlight the exploration quest, because that way you take an efficient route. You're going to get the nodes for the coins between the exploration nodes. And one of the exploration nodes is close to the races. So that way you're just going in one path.
Grand, isn't it? The Superman Memorial Statue in Centennial Park. Otherwise known as beginner targeting practice for the city's pigeon population. Speaking of, I need to go look up old Super Chump. If he's gonna fight against Brainiac, that boy is gonna need a brain!
And since this is a new character, he doesn't have the quest for locating the random appearances of Mixius Spitalik. So I'm going to try to pass across those. One of them is here, and he's not there right now. And when you get these nodes, you only want to hit it 3 times. Like, not like this idiot, like he just kind of Hulk smashed it. If you see someone do that, just leave the node. Because you're not going to get 8. There's a total of 8.
Go get a real job.
If you do it perfectly, there's 8 in each pot. So you hit it 2 or 3 times first, you'll get 1.
hands off the stash, Earth chump! Killjoy, don't you like dancing?
Then you tap it 3 times next. You should get 2. Tap it another 3 times for 2 more. And then the last time will give you 3 for a total of 8.
Time is up, super chump!
Okay, so that was the node with the speakers. With that one, you have to hit the speakers first, otherwise they're going to keep stunning you. Now the first one's free because you don't know what type of node it is.
Think fast!
So now we've got the rock. And here comes
Watch
that same idiot as before,
kids.
Probably.
Way to the world got you down. No more golden coins for you.
Oh, so on this character, I actually have to do the race. But as you see, if I move into the race circle, it already completes that quest.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Hey, follow me!
As I remember, this is a pretty long one. And you're gonna get stunned in some areas. But if I remember correctly, it is pretty lenient.
Hey, this way!
There we go. Now I don't have to do that again for the rest of the event. But as you can see, that was pretty lenient. I never feel good about the flight races, but somehow you end up with platinum usually. Okay, off to the Daily Planet. There are a bunch of nodes around this area, but I'm gonna try to.
Ah, the Daily Planet building.
Hang on.
If you squint through that Brainiac bottle haze. You can see the tiny dark speck of Lois Lane throwing herself out the window, hoping that Superman will rescue her. I'm always waiting for the day he doesn't. Hasn't happened yet, but I can hope.
Right now it seems pretty crowded out here, so I'm gonna veer off from the regular path to see if I could get some isolated nodes. Two. Okay, now this one is the Fool's Gold, so you're going to pick up the gold coins and ignore the green one, because otherwise it's going to bounce you away. Now for this one, you have to be careful if they're close to each other, because sometimes it'll make you activate the green one. And also, depending on where they bounce, sometimes you can't get to them.
Super chump.
Like in that case. Same with the one with the falling rock. Like, sometimes you can't get to them all.
Run.
I don't think they're generous enough with the timer, because it doesn't take that into account.
Killjoy, don't you like dancing?
For almost all of these types, you're going to use only weapon attacks because you want to be precise and you don't want to hit it too many times. The only case where you would use a power is there's one where leprechauns come out.
Coins it'll take to get him out of our dimension, but I hope we reach that mysterious number soon.
Yeah, the one with the leprechauns though, you're going to get two little leprechauns that come out each time you release the coins. And what you want to do is find an AoE power that hits the leprechauns but not the pot. I believe every power has one of those.
Here we have Metropolis City Hall, the hub of municipal government for the city, where you earth tools have something called laws. I myself was mayor once. Everything was going great until I was forced to take extended leave back in the fifth dimension. Rest assured that any time you want to do community service for the greater good, ultimately Super Goon will show up and ruin it. It's the Metropolis Museum of Art! Too bad Brainiac decided to become an art collector and bottle the whole building. In the fifth dimension, we don't hang art on the walls. It's used for a more, sanitary purpose. Kerflush! But you earth dopes seem to love the stuff. Saps.
Alright, let's complete the quests. So the exploration one, get 4 clovers. And a fool is gold. You get 6 for a total of 10. And you'll randomly get the clover bombs, which you need to throw 20 to get a feat. I'm pretty sure you don't get those every time. So what I'm doing now is I'm trying to remember one of the Mixes Pitalic nodes. I thought there was one along this street. I think I took a wrong turn, but anyway, you only have to get that 5 times, so if you miss it on a few days, it's okay. But let me pick this up on another character so we can see some more variety with the pots.
Greetings and salutations, Earth idiot! I am Mr. Mixius Spitalik, A being from the fifth dimension. I understand you Earth chumps have a legend about little green men. Well, how could I resist? Gather all 33 of me golden coins from pots of gold all over Metropolis. If you can.
Actually, let's take a quick look at the vendor as well. I forgot to go over that as a villain. Now, the things you want are... let's see, the one nice emerald is a single collection piece. Like, it'll complete the collection if you get this. And that awards you a leprechaun for your base. And that's similar to Valentine's Day's Love Crystal, where it gives you a drop per day, and there's two items inside that drop, one of which could be a collection. The only difference is you actually have to... It's more interactive than the Valentine's Day one. Like, you don't get the item straight up. You have to chase these coins around your base. I mean, that's kind of fun once, maybe, but it gets annoying because it obviously takes more time than the Valentine's Day one. So that's what this piece is. The second item is probably the final piece to the collection you're getting from that base item. In the first item, the nice emerald. So what you want to do is get the emerald first, and play that game daily and see how far you get. And if you get pretty close, then you buy this one towards the end of the event. I believe this awards an aura, but I'm not totally sure. Next item, the speaker, just is a base item that plays music. I don't think there's any feat behind that. It's just a cool item. So if you have 50 to spare, that's one you get for fun. The style feat is only two items this time around. It's the crown and a pot of gold backpack. So that will get you the style feat for 2017. For the base items, there are a lot of new ones, but it's only the six rocks towards the feet. The other items are variants, like different colors of previous years. So the bar stools, I think they were blue last year. And then these are variant coins from last year. So if you're looking at the minimum, you're going to need six base items, two styles, and then the two collection items. Which, that's still quite a bit. With this being two events, I'm pretty sure you're going to have to buy. But if you run alts, I believe everything is tradable except the styles. So you could work alts to do this. Alright, let's move to Metropolis. So I think in this quest for the coins, we're missing two types. We didn't see the leprechaun one, and we didn't see the one where you need to talk to Mixes Pitalik. Now the hero route is slightly more efficient because you're going to come across more nodes. It's further away from the Daily Planet. So just like the villain one, I'm going to highlight the exploration one, and that's the path we're going to follow. But from the Midtown Station on Hero side, you're going to come across a node here, one on either side of this intersection. There are actually a lot on this street, but I'm just going to follow the path. And actually, I'm not sure if this tune is new or not. Not sure if I had him last year. And I did, because he has clovers. So he probably has the locate Mixes Pitalik. But I won't spoil this node. But that's one location. See, I didn't come across that on the villain side, because the villains don't pass by here. And there was a location by City Hall that I forgot about.
Grand, isn't it? The Superman Memorial Statue in Centennial Park. Otherwise known as beginner targeting practice for the city's pigeon population. Speaking of, I need to go look up old Super Chump. If he's gonna fight against Brainiac, that boy is gonna need a brain!
So right now I'm going along the common path. And this is the unfinished one. Yeah, you're gonna come across unfinished ones. Because if you have to get 33. If you do all the nodes perfectly, you end up with 32. See, like, that guy grabbed one of the green coins. As much as possible, it's better to do this one by yourself.
Mr. Mixius Pitlick never gives away anything for free, Buck. Don't ignore me!
Okay, this is the one where you have to talk to him. So what you want to do is stand by him and then range the pot, but this guy's going to screw it up.
Come talk to me now, or else. I demand your immediate attention!
Okay, actually he didn't. There are actually a few players who do it correctly. And as you can see, my confidence in the player base is pretty low. But there are good ones out there.
Help!
Alright, so we're just missing the leprechaun one.
The golden rule on this dumb planet? That's my stuff! Come talk to me now, or else.
I usually just stand next to him.
I demand your immediate attention!
Just in case it's this type.
Don't ignore me!
And this guy knows what he's doing too.
No more golden coins for you!
Yeah, see, the race is white for this character because I already ran it last year. So once I step into the circle, I get the quest complete.
Ah, the Daily Planet building. If you squint through that Brainiac bottle haze, you can see the tiny dark speck of Lois Lane throwing herself out the window, hoping that Superman will rescue her. I'm always waiting for the day he doesn't. Hasn't happened yet, but I can hope!
And I'm going off to the side again to get some isolated nodes. See if we can get that last type.
Get your hands off of me, golden coins! Killjoy! Don't you like dancing? Hey! The gold ATM is now closed for business! Go get a real job!
Sometimes these coins are unresponsive too, like,
get
it's like
your hands off
you'll be standing right
coins.
Next to it and it won't do anything.
Don't ignore me!
Now this guy's gonna screw it up, so what you do is just leave the node, leave it to him. Let him screw up on his own. A lot of people in this area. Looks
hands
like we're not gonna
the
get the leprechaun.
Earth, chump. Those are my Killjoy! Don't you like dancing?
Excellent.
That's 33.
He collected Mr. Mixia's Spidelix coins. Maybe now he will leave. If Superman can't force him out of this dimension, no one can.
Okay, yeah, the note I missed for finding Mixx Spidelix is right here. See there? Yeah, this is one of the spawn points. So it's also on the way to exploration.
Here we have Metropolis City Hall, the hub of municipal government for the city, where you Earth tools have something called laws. I myself was mayor once. Everything was going great until I was forced to take extended leave back in the fifth dimension. Rest assured that any time you want to do community service for the greater good, ultimately Super Goon will show up and ruin it. It's the Metropolis Museum of Art. Too bad Brainiac decided to become an art collector and bottle the whole building. In the fifth dimension, we don't hang art on the...
So as you can see, this event completes pretty quickly for the 10 marks. So it's a little easier to run like several tunes through this. And you'll see something popular in this event is a lot of players will just create tunes, get them off the ship just to do the event. Like you'll see characters with random names. They'll just like push anything on the keyboard, create the character, and run the event for the 10 marks. So it's an easy one to farm with alts. But there's no alert to it. It's just those three open world items, two of which will award you the currency. Okay, I think two runs is good enough. It would have been good if we got the leprechaun for the full variety, the leprechaun pot node. But I think this is good enough. One on hero side, one on villain side. So good luck with the event, and thanks for watching.